Lord, if you're back with another video, in today's video I'm showing you another custom fig barf based off Nintendo 64. And as you, if you didn't see my how to build of Conker, here he is right now, and this is the Conker fig barf I have ready. I am posting this sometime this week on my account. I don't know when exactly, but I will be posting it. So yeah, we got a couple good brick built figures and along with minifigures. We'll take a look at the minifigure first, and then we'll go up the scale of like brick built and semi brick built and stuff. So yeah. So take a look at our first brick built. I mean, not brick built, but our first figure, and I'm gonna just piece and this, and we'll take a look at Conker, who's the main character of the game. I did find my frying pan piece. He does have that as his weapon in the game. We move to the back. Got a little tail. I know it's not color accurate to these, but it. It works the best, and it works best for him in game. So yeah, and he does have a frying pan, and he does have the mid leg. There's nothing else much to say here. If you want to check out the build, how to build him, I will leave a link in the description of how to build him. So yeah, this is Conker. Now I'll take a look at the next figure. Our next figure is Greg the Grim Reaper, which is a really funny character, as he really has the high-pitched voice. Has like a giant one of these like scythes, and I try to make mine giant, but I didn't want to make mine super giant. So yeah, it's enough so you can hold it. He is very small. And yeah, there's not a lot to say here. It's just a normal Grim Reaper just with tiny legs, basically. That's all it is. And he's a funny character, and I just thought to add him. So yeah, we'll take a look at the next one. The next figure is supposed to be Uga. I think that's how you say it. It's spelled U-G-A. And they have a club as their weapon. And some of them have these like little headbands that I didn't put one on. Now, there is a better torso that... other than the Catman torso that you can use for him, and that is the series 17 circus guy, which I do have. I don't know where it is at the moment. So yeah, I use the Catman one. I use Tracer's hip. You can use any orange hip, like orange shell. And I blue mid leg that they had like blue feet, and I thought the mid legs worked better. And I just gave him some yellow hands and arms. Then I used the Ninjago movie Cole, which is also like head, which is also in a lot of sets nowadays of Ninjago. So yeah, that's an Uga, I think that's how you say. So now we'll take a look at our semi figures, which are kind of like brick built and non brick built at the same time, and non figure at the same time. So our first one is Birdie, as he's like a scarecrow, and he like moves around and sing. I know I'm using a few that don't like. That doesn't look right, but it's mainly from the front you're gonna look at him, and he does move around like whoa, whoa, whoa. And I had a hard time trying to find a good yellow head for him, as he's a yellow scarecrow. And I also used the yellow spaceman helmet. I used Star-Lord torso, as you can tell from the back. I used the lightsaber thing in brown, like a dark brown, and I just set that there for him. He could just do, and I just deck him onto something. So. Yeah, oh, there he goes, flying off. Yeah, we'll put him back on his little thing, and then we'll take a look at our last brick-built figure base thing. So for this one, we're moving this out of the way, as he doesn't really need it. As he's on his little own chair thing, this is the Professor Zimilk. As he's has the, got some milk that the Panther, King Panther drinks. Right here, I used the martini glass from, where'd that go? There it is. From the Harry Potter series, 2. I just put a white stud in it, so that way he can hold the glass of milk. And then I have a little chair. Oh, I never noticed that crack right there. But yeah, it's a nice little chair build, and my little, different, build for this little thing that he usually has on his back. It's supposed to be, like, lightning thing. And this is, like, the best I can do at the moment, like, because I don't know where mine is. It's somewhere up in my studio. There it is. Actually, I just found it really quickly. And he's dead. He died. Part of his head fell. Okay, so we'll put this on real quick. Sorry, my video ended a little bit. So, yeah. We're going to pick up here. Like, I accidentally ended it. But, yeah, here's the Professor. He's pretty nice. He doesn't have really any legs. So I, like, made him half body. And he does have a little bit of, like, hip. So I'd use that piece. And you can see the chair. It's still an interesting build. Here's the back of the chair. Might do a separate video on how to build his chair. Yeah, you got a little lightning thing, like, and you got his eye, like his eye, his big eye, like that he has. So yeah, that's the Professor. Now I'll take a look at the brick built figures. we'll take a look at the tiny one first. So we got the green stuff, or the cache, as our first little brick built character, as I'll have to zoom in a lot. And it was a little challenging to do that. The cache had like eyeballs and had like a stripe right here in the middle of it. I didn't really want to draw over my stuff right now, so I tried to build like a little thing for it. I mean, I think it gets the job across that it's cache. And then, yeah, we got, so I'll just move this one out of the way, and then we'll take a look at our next one, which is the sweet corn. And we do have a third one, scared one. These are just little bricks with the eyes on them that I got a while ago from someone, like, you know, a little tin of old parts that I got, like, back in the summer. So I thought these worked well for the sweet corn. They usually have two eyes, but it works well for one because they're tiny, tiny, and they look cool like that. So yeah, it's the sweet corn. Now I'll take a look at the brick built guys. All right, so our first brick built figure, doesn't really need to fit on there, is the Mighty Pooh. We'll put him on here for real quick as we can get a 360 look at him. He was very challenging to build. So yeah, the Great Mighty Pooh is his name. And he's a giant blob of poop that tries to throw his poop at you. And he likes to eat sweet corn. And he's holding one in the battle. So that's why I put the scared one right here. Like, please help me. So yeah, we gave him yellow eyes. I think that looks good. And if you remove the little mouth, I think this works well for the mouth. This piece comes from the Dewback set. I got mine from there. And also the slave one. But see, there's a little red. That's supposed to represent like a tongue area. I know he doesn't really have a red tongue in the game, but it just looks nice. We got some like little like textures right here, up here, here. And for the hand, I use these little black claws that I don't have any brown claw pieces. And I use the Commando Droid Battle Body from the Bark Speeder set that I got many years ago. There's nothing on the back because you really would just look at them at the front like this. And it's just like a little rotating hand that goes wing, 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 wing. Yeah, there's not a lot to say about the Great Mighty Pooh. He's very simple. I might do a how to build on him. So yeah, if you like this, we'll move on to our last big boy character. Our last figure is the Panther King. He's like one of the main characters that you like that story progresses through. Now mine isn't the best. This actually literally took me like 50 minutes just to build like properly. Like I know it's not perfect, but it was very difficult to do. I think I got it kind of well. It was the difficult part was mainly the head. The hands were pretty easy to do. I just had to figure out how to like align them like with stuff. And he can be like, bring me the milk. And he can just take his milk and it doesn't really fit. And this part's like really loose. This is the main body. And you can see there's a lot of back stuff. And we got a lot of legs. We'll just move these like this. But yeah. It's supposed to be like the middle of the thing where it closes up. And then you can just put him like this. It's like very difficult to stay connected. He's a big fella. And also you got his little teeny tiny crown up there. And the head looks very weird. Yeah, I know. It's not the best. But this was very difficult to build. As like, it's just pretty cool. And it's just falling apart too at the same time. But it's pretty cool at the same time just to have like this brick built figure of the main guy that's around in the game. As I might do a how to build on this, a little difficult. But yeah, I think it might have its own how to build. As I couldn't find any good quality pieces at the time, too, so that's why his hands are gold. As I used mostly my parts from Molten Man, they finally took mine apart because I have really no use for it. I really wanted a set for the figure, but I kind of liked the build at the time. Now I just don't know what to use it build, so yeah, we just, and yeah, so this is, Panther King, and that's our last figure, and he's the big boy of the thing, as he's, like, pretty tall compared to a figure. We'll put his arm down, and we'll just compare him to Conker. I see it's, like, Conker's, like, barely even half his height. Like, that's crazy. So, we'll get my, we'll get Captain Rex out. He kind of will modify, so he's a little taller. But the normal height for a figure is the Kashyyyk Trooper, and he's about the same as Rex, just Rex is a little taller because of the added pieces. So yeah, this is the Conker Fig Barf, and we'll take a look at everyone, and then we'll end the video. Okay, so this is everyone in the Fig Barf. I hope you guys like this, like, build and how to build, like, on these extremities. There will be probably bigger hot to build in the future on some of these. But anyways, I hope you guys like this video. Please like and subscribe. Comment down below your thoughts on what you want me to do next. I shall see you guys in the next video.